Dear colleagues, the thought that this time of year sees some of us shivering beneath a blanket of snow, while others are basking in a hot sun, clearly depicts the extraordinarily wide scope of our international psychoanalytical association. Such a diverse and complex geographical and cultural reality requires us, but also enables us, to cultivate with pride the vision of a shared IPA mentality beyond borders of country, continent, and school. A spirit that characterizes us in our quest to continue the work begun by Sigmund Freud and that unites us in a changing world, as is the theme of our next IPA Congress in Boston in 2015. These New Year greetings provide a traditional opportunity for the IPA president to inform members about the general situation of our association and ongoing initiatives. And once again this year, I'm pleased to send this message out to you all in our four official languages. In the meantime, a team of 63 colleagues from almost 20 countries, coordinated by the IPA website editorial board, are translating these notes into many other languages to reach even more colleagues across the globe. This is part of the initiative which began a year ago to bridge our communities and promote a collective participation, an initiative of which we are proud. 2014 was not an easy year in many parts of the world. In some countries, psychoanalysts have found themselves working under conditions of war, Israel and Ukraine, political and social upheaval, Venezuela, and severe economic crisis, Argentina, Greece, Italy, Portugal and Spain, among others, that have heavily affected clinical and scientific activity. But psychoanalysis has a powerful internal driving force. The societies have gone ahead with their work and scientific exchanges have continued to thrive despite the difficulties. I would like to dedicate these opening notes to the 2015 IPA Congress to be held in Boston, Massachusetts, USA. A Congress full of innovation that is already attracting enormous interest, judging by the number of scientific proposals received. This Congress brings together psychoanalysts from all over the world for an intercontinental debate at the highest scientific level, and is at the apex of continuing education for psychoanalysts. The pre-Congress will host several sections: neurosciences, mental health field events, outreach seminars and conferences for students and professionals, as well as working parties and work groups with a wide range of proposals, all in a spectacular natural setting on the ocean front and with a university campus atmosphere. The most important innovation will be the Boston groups. Groups of 15 colleagues, 5 Europeans, 5 Latin Americans, and 5 North Americans, who will begin their exchanges online in the months leading up to the Congress, discussing by internet the material provided by the keynote speakers. Registration for the Boston groups has already opened, so that the groups will be fully formed and working before they actually meet in person in Boston. Then, during the Congress, there will be a slot after the keynotes for the groups to meet in person to discuss the themes and continue their exchange of ideas with the help of a facilitator. We think that this experience will encourage the process of true internationalization of psychoanalysis, with shared knowledge and direct exchanges, and will help to enhance the sense of an IPA mentality, which is so dear to our administration. This same philosophy drives the work of the group of analysts who, for several months now, have been contributing to the IPA Encyclopedic Dictionary of Psychoanalysis, an ambitious work in progress intended to represent the various developments of the psychoanalytic world by illustrating both the history of the various concepts and terms and their specific evolution within the different cultures that form part of our scientific community. We are going ahead with the equally ambitious reorganization of the entire communication area. This project focuses on innovative technologies and new ways to communicate both internally within the IPA and externally. The new website, with its wealth of information and ever-evolving interactive debates across the continents, is progressively gaining the dimension of agora, a meeting place for interchange and dialogue that we have envisioned since the beginning of our mandate. And in conjunction with this, I also want to mention the transformation that is underway in many committees, which are evolving from the sole function of regulators to a much more vibrant role as organizers of scientific activities at the highest level in various fields, promoting meetings and dialogues also outside our biennial congresses. The process of internationalization of psychoanalytic culture is carried forward also by the joint venture with the regional federations for the creation of the new electronic journal, psychoanalysis.today, whose structure and whose editorial board are almost complete and which will be launched in the first quarter of 2015 with an original formula entirely different from that of other specialized publications. As promised, our commitment to connecting with the mental health field is also going ahead through the work of our committee and constructive contacts with the World Psychiatric Association. Thanks to these contacts, I was recently invited to speak at the joint WPIA-INA-HSERPS International Conference in Athens, opening a dialogue of mutual respect and acknowledgement between our professions. Continuing the theme of the IPA's presence in major worldwide organizations, we also participated through our accredited representative in the United Nations meeting in Vienna in October with the support of our UN committee. In addition, we have created an ad hoc committee to interact with the World Health Organization. Within our organization, through the continual work of the IPA board, we are involved in a series of institutional improvements and developments. I will mention only a few here. The reorganization of our administrative hub at Broomhills, the review of our ethics code, the debate on training as part of a forum between the society training directors, which will be extended to an online debate between all IPA members in March, the expansion of psychoanalysis into new geographic territories, the review of the guidelines for sponsoring and liaison committees, a first phase for a configuration of the basic principles relating to the problematic area of remote analysis, the startup of the activities of the new Psychoanalysis and Law Committee. I'll stop there, but I can assure you that if 2014 was a year of very intense work and commitment for all those who give their time and energy to serving the IPA, 2015 is set to be no less. So, in this New Year message, allow me to join together with my fellow IPA board representatives, the Broomhills staff, the chairs and members of our committees and task forces, and of course our Vice President Alexander Billinghurst, our Treasurer Juan Carlos Weissman, and our Executive Director Paul Craig. From all of us, best wishes to you and your families for a peaceful and fruitful 2015 in the spirit of the fascinating daily adventure that is our psychoanalysis.